Let's talk about the difference between normal hair loss versus pathological hair loss. Okay. Now you have hundreds of thousands of hairs growing on your head at any one given time, and the life cycle of a hair is between 2 and 5 years. In a normal situation, an average person will lose between 50 to 100 strands of hair every single day. So the way that you would figure this out is you just rub your fingers through your hair with a gentle tug, and you should see anywhere between 1 and 10 hairs in your hand. And that is normal. But if you keep doing the same spot over and over and it keeps coming out, there's several reasons for this. The biggest reason is there's some type of hormonal change going on. Let's say you just gave birth or you are going through menopause. This means that your estrogen is high and your progesterone is low. Also, if you have high levels of a hormone called DHT, which is a powerful form of testosterone, that can cause hair loss, and that condition is called alopecia. And then if your thyroid is low, that can also cause hair loss. Most hypothyroid conditions are autoimmune, and that would be Hashimoto's. And so that's not really a true thyroid problem, it's an immune problem. I put some links down below for more information on that topic. Now, if your cortisol is too high because your stress is too high, that can also cause hair loss. Also, you can lose your hair with certain medications, especially birth control pills, which again is the added estrogen. Antidepressant medication, as well as anti-anxiety medication, can also cause hair loss. As well as taking insulin if you're diabetic, that can lead to hair loss. Now, if you have an autoimmune condition called lupus, that's one cause. And another big cause of hair loss is nutrient deficiencies. So if you're low in vitamin D, B12, vitamin C, vitamin A, especially zinc, which is very common, low in biotin, which normally comes because there's some problem in your gut. Let's say you've had antibiotics, for example, then that's going to kill off the microbes that actually make biotin, and that can lead to hair loss. I have a video on that, and I list it down below. And also, if you're low on selenium, which is a mineral that helps you convert T4 to T3, the active form of the thyroid hormone. So low selenium can cause a conversion problem with your thyroid, and that can lead to hair loss. If you have not seen some of my other videos on hair loss, I've done quite a few. I listed them down below. Check them out.